Hello, so in the last video we were looking at this. You can hear that the break just isn't lining up very well if we listen to the whole thing. It's just not matching the CPS. So what we could do is kind of try and match the CPS to it. Yeah, now it's just got a gap, so I need to speed it up. It would, yeah, I could load it in a sound editor and measure how long that loop should be, but it's not going to be fun to find the exact amount. But there are more flexible ways of doing it. Actually, that sounds okay now. But actually, we could keep it at a different BPM or CPS and use a function to slice it into the right part. So let's try that. There's quite a few ways of doing this. To start with, we'll look at slice and splice. So let's try this. Oh, that's interesting. Yeah, so I've cut it into 8 bits and I'm playing each bit one after the other and it's making a strange noise. Maybe I just need to slow this down. Oh, I see what's happened. I've set the CPS too high. I meant to set that to 0.7. That makes more sense. Okay. Right, so if I get rid of that. So now when I change the CPS, you can hear the break drops in pitch and slows down to match the CPS exactly. And that's because I'm using splice. I think splice is a lot of fun. So one thing we could do with this is actually start patterning this out. So now I've made those two happen in one step and then put a rest there. I can just mess around with this as much as I like. I can slow it down, as you've already seen. I could pattern this, so the first half would be normal and the second half would be slow. So that's fun. I really recommend playing with splice. There's also slice, which is similar but doesn't do the pitching thing. So in this case, the bits won't line up and they'll start overlapping. Because I've cut it into 8 parts, it doesn't sound so bad. It still sounds like I'm hitting the drums in time. So yeah, it's a matter of taste and what you're trying to do to choose which one you want to use in a particular situation. Okay, one nice thing about this, as an aside, is that if I slice this 4-4 pattern into 8 bits, I don't actually have to keep that 4-4 time signature. Like, I just could just play the first 6 bits of it. And then I've got a nice 3-4 pattern, I think it will be called. So if I then... So even though you've got a 4-4 pattern, you can... That doesn't mean you have to stay in 4-4. You can mess around with it as much as you like. I can't resist trying out Jux Rev on this. Jux Rev almost always makes things sound better. Okay. Who's going to make the t-shirt with Jux Rev on? It's always good to have an in-joke. Okay, I think I'll leave it at that. There are other ways to mess around with samples, which I'll look at in the next video. So thanks for watching.